KLOK 1170 AM, San Jose, San Francisco, and the entire Bay Area.
Awesome, hey, hey, baby, this is Geek and Dando.
Due to new tax reforms, taxes are becoming more complicated. Let NRI Tax Group help you with your tax filing, accounting services, new business incorporation, late reporting on FBAR, or any other international tax reporting. We can help you save up to 25% in taxes with proper tax planning and filing. Call Shamshara Graywall at 408-316-4490 to schedule an appointment or go to NRITaxGroup.com. That's NRITaxGroup.com.
Are you looking for a fiduciary certified financial planner who can help you with your wealth management, retirement planning such as 401k and IRA, life insurance policies, your kids' educational planning, estate planning, tax planning and tax filing all under one roof? Hi, this is Ladi Chuti, a fiduciary certified financial planner. Call me at 408-373-5570 to schedule your initial free consultation or go to NRIWealth.com. That's NRIWealth.com.
Are you looking for a summer camp for your children? Give them a chance to spend 5 weeks improving math and English academic skills at Iden Summer Bootcamp. Our carefully constructed programs are exclusively designed for students of different grade and skill levels and allow our students to catch up academically and excel beyond their knowledge. They'll also dive deeper in their interests and, of course, have a lot of fun.
Give us a call at 833-IGEN-KID or visit our website, iGEN.school, to sign up right now and get an early bird discount or new family discount.
London, India, or whatever's on your bucket list. Our mission at Travelopod is to get you the lowest fare on your flights. Travelopod, best deals and service guaranteed. Call us today.
Call Travelopod to get special deals not available online. Travelopod, best deals always.
S for Friday, S for fun, and S for the fantastic real estate connection show with Ann Gupta and Rohit Mohan. Power up your Friday by learning about real estate and mortgage news, trends, upcoming markets, and much, much more. Tune in and call in to be a part of the show every Friday, 8:30 to 9 a.m. Only on Radio Zindagi, Jeeja.
At Radio Zindagi 1170 AM HD, we don't just run your ad. We go all the way with you to develop the idea, strategy, and implementation planning to get your product, your service, your business, or message across to the diverse South Asian population in the San Francisco Bay Area. To inquire about our packages, call 510-387-5381 or visit radiozindagi.com/contact.
Shirdi Sai Darbar at 255 San Jerome Mumbai Sunnyvale invites everyone on the 3-day grand event of Shri Maharudra Yajna.
June 21st, 22nd, 23rd.
Rare opportunity to contribute and participate to receive Shiva's blessings. Priceless opportunity to the Maharudra Yajna right here in the Bay Area. First time in Baba Temple. Performed in the most authentic Mahanava Ukt by 121 Ritwis. 11 Thunders, 1,331 Rudram chanting. Puja cost free and free blessed Sai to all Suvasians participants in Mahalakshmi Deepam Puja on Friday, June 21st. Not only this, free blessed Shri Sai Idol to all participants on June 23rd. And all Ritwiks will be getting dhoti set, shawl, panchpatra set, silver covered Rudraksha mala and prasad pack too.
For more details, log on to Shri Sai Darbar. .org or call 408-482-0089.
With the continuing uncertainty in the financial market, now is the time to purchase or refinance. Locked in low rates, which we may never see again, this is a perfect time to change your arm to fixed. Even if your rates are not quite where you want them to be, call us so we can lock your rates to fund your loan as soon as we get any better at any point. Call RateBeat at 877-877-7575 or visit RateBeat.com. As you see, call RateBeat at 877-877-7575 and it will help me handle RateBeat LLC NMLS ID 126 and 188.
Goodbye! बिन बुलाए मेहमानों का तो कोई पता नहीं, लेकिन बाहर से आ रहे मेहमानों का हमेशा पता करें, क्योंकि उनके आने से पहले हमें लेना है विजिटर इंश्योरेंस,
वो भी visitorplans.com से।
To get the best quote and buy online, visit visitorplans.com. They have the best insurance and they can help in claim process too. Everything to give you peace of mind. They have support 24/7 in case of medical emergency. So visit visitorplans.com or call 855-5-VISITOR.
आवाज होगी बुलंद जब स्वरों का होगा मिलन, सर झुका के करेंगे सजदा संगीत में होके मगन।
Bollywood events and as you like it presents
The Sufi Queen is Black, Sajda.
Richa Sharma live in concert on 22nd June, Saturday, 8 p.m. onwards at City National Civic, San Jose.
For sponsorship and tickets,
call Ray Sharma 510-728-7653 or Meg David 510-334-7683
or log on to Sureka.com. 50% off on Richa Sharma's ticket.
Hi, I'm Manoj Joshi, Youth Personal Life Coach.
Tune into our exclusive radio show Life Coach 101 every Thursday 12 to 12:30 p.m. with wellness guru and spiritual healer Manoj Joshi. Only on Radio Zindagi, GHR.
Let's begin our new life with new life and achieve real success and happiness.
Vakratunda Mahakam.
Radio Zindagi 1170 AM is proud to bring Bay Area's most loved and celebrated Ganesh Utsav back to the city of Newark on 7th and 8th of September at the New Park Mall.
The most festive Ganesh Mela with puja, aarties, performances, food, shopping, kids activities, Ganesh Visarjan, and the star attraction this year will be the Siddhi Vinayak Dabrushi and Tirupati Balaji Ganpati Darshan.
Associate partners of Na Bazaar. Event powered by Travelport. Shah of Ecosources in Genius Kids Preschool and After School. Realtor Amit and Redukar Namdar. Event supported by Attorney Gopal Krishna of Allied Legal, Safari Kids Preschool and After School, Realtor Lavanya Dubhi, Shalu and Dharminder Devan of Project Kids, Realtor Shreem Deon and LabVox Shreepal.
For booth and sponsorship, contact Senba or Neeraj at 510-387-5381 or email booth@radiozindagi.com. For performances, email
Terminating with over 50,000 watts of power, the Shah Peerally Law Show, and all your views matter.
Every Thursday, 10 to 11 a.m., only on Radio Zindagi, GHR.
HD.
Aya. Oh my god.
Actually, my idea. Radio Zindagi is now HD.
The views, opinions, and statements expressed in the following program reflect the views of the program contributors and do not necessarily reflect views of CAB Broadcasting LLC and its management or its sponsors.
Hello, everybody. Assalamu alaikum, sastakar, namaskar to all the listeners. This is Attorney Shah Peerally for the Shah Peerally Law Show. And last week we had I was not feeling well, so we had to have, we had a recorded show. I apologize for that. And today, hopefully, if you have any questions, I will be opening the lines as much as possible. 510-657-1170, and I have Michael with me on the board, and anything I'm telling you today is for educational purposes only. You should not act or refrain to act solely on the information provided. You should contact an attorney if you have any questions. And of course, we're going to talk about different issues of immigration. All those things are very, very convoluted right now. A lot of things happening at the same time. A lot of things not happening. It's really a war zone, quote unquote, out there. And talking about war, I just hope and pray that we don't go to war with Iran, because that's going to be really bad for everybody. So we have enough wars out there. So let's see how things are going to unfold in the U.S. And this is definitely, there will be, we are expecting, of course, more enforcement, more crackdown, and more denials, of course. And that's really the sad part of it. and delays. A lot of people are upset because their EADs are getting delays, H4 EADs, you name it, I-45 EADs, and etc., etc. A lot of people are getting delayed. So we're going to talk about as many subjects as possible, but since I was not there last week, I will allow people to call earlier, 510-657-1170. 510-657-1170. This is the number to the studio. And if you want to call our office, 510-742-5887. 510-742-5887. The website to check attorneyonair.com. attorneyonair.com. And now, again, like I said, 510-657-1170. And we are today is June 20th, 2019, and we're live. This is Attorney Shah Peerally. So feel free, if you're hearing this show another day, that means it's a recorded show. But once in a while, I have to do that because it gets really kind of, sometimes I get busy and I'm not able to do the shows live, but today is live. So feel free to call if you have any questions on H1B, L1, you name it, anything immigration, adjustment of status, family petitions, asylum, all those you can call. So today I'm going to talk a little bit about situations of U visas, FAWAs, and I'll also talk a little bit about everything pretty much as I can talk about today. So let us start a little bit with family petitions, VAWA. VAWA is Violence Against Women. It's a very interesting law. It was kind of proposed by Joe Biden a long time ago, I think in 1992, and it kept getting renewed every year, although this year they are trying their best not to renew it. What VAWA does, it allows people who are abused to actually get what we call a green card, if they are married to a green card holder or a U.S. citizen. And you need three basic requirements for VAWA. Number one, you have to have a genuine marriage, that means a bona fide marriage between you and your spouse. And then the second element that you need, you have to have been abused. Abused means doesn't mean you have to have been physically abused. Abuse can be mental, can be emotional, can be verbal, can be physical, of course, can be sexual, can be different kind, but it's all core. And the third part that you need is that you have to have good moral character. And we have been doing VAWAs for a lot of people for years, and we have been very successful. And if you need help, 510-742-5887. I think we have a couple of callers, right, Michael? Let me take the callers. Shah, right? You're live in here. Hello.
Hi, Mr. Shah. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir. I can hear you very well. Go ahead.
Yes. Thanks for taking my call. I have a question about N-400 filing. I was wondering how much time is each stage after filing N-400 taking these days, and how much time does the total process take?
Okay, where are you filing? Which area? San Francisco area?
Bay Area.
Either Santa Clara or San Francisco. It's taking around 8 months, actually. 8 months, but unfortunately, San Francisco, I think, is going slower. It's going almost in 1 year. But it's an average between 6 months to 1 year. Santa Clara is a little bit less, but it's very hard to tell because, unfortunately, now what they're doing extensive background check, and that's what's delaying the cases. But the average time is between 6 months to 1 year, but most of the cases are processed 8 months.
I see. And do we get to pick whether our application goes to Santa Clara or San Francisco?
No. It goes by your jurisdiction. That means if you live in that jurisdiction, it will be served by the specific jurisdiction, okay?
I see. And if you could also elaborate how much time each step in the process takes, like fingerprinting, interview,
okay.
And all.
Okay. So basically, once you file the case, if it is properly filed, you should get a fingerprint between 6 weeks to 8 weeks, okay? And that, I'm giving you a general timeline because sometimes it takes more. So then after that, usually you will get your interview, which is taking around 6 months to 1 year. And then after you pass the interview, usually if everything is fine, they will clear you, and they will send you within 30 days, or right there they will tell you, okay, you pass, and they are going to grant you the ability and a specific gate to go and take the oath. So that's pretty much it. Now, if there's any kind of issues, then the case can get delayed. One of the biggest issues we see is background check, because there was something called CARB, where they basically block cases from India, etc. So it is a smooth process, but at the same time now they have made it difficult. That's all.
I see. Okay, makes sense. Thank you so much for your information.
No problem. So, yes, you're welcome. Let me take another call. This is Shah, you're live in here.
Hello? Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. Go ahead.
Yeah. So I have a question, sir. I actually lost my job in January this year and was able to find a different job. I'm on an H-1 visa, and currently the approval has not been received. It's still in the processing stage, and I see it takes around 13 months for the approval to be received under normal processing. So that being said, should I wait for the approval before I try to switch jobs again?
Okay, you got laid off, and then you transferred to another company, right?
Correct, yes.
And then now the company filed an extension for you.
No, the company applied for my H-1B, but it has not been approved.
Okay.
Based on the receipt, I joined the company.
Okay. But they have not done it under premium, right?
No, they suggested do not do it under premium because you do not have anything to call back if there's a demand.
Yeah, that's true. But remember, you have only 240 days you can continue working. So that's important. But now if you want to move to another company, it becomes a little bit more complicated. What you have to do, you can still do it. You should do it as a counselor processing. So that means you file the case, not as a transfer, but basically under a counselor processing. That means the case will be sent to a U.S. consulate, where you go for an interview, you get a stamp. Do you have a stamp on your passport?
Yes, but it has expired.
Okay, so you will need to get a new stamp and come back. Now, there's another way to do that. You can do it through a bridge. That means the pending case, you can try to figure out on it and try to file it. But it's not really a good approach. Although it is possible, I don't recommend it. So the best is just to, you can, yeah, get another company, file the case, but put it as a counselor processing.
Counselor processing. Okay.
Okay.
And here, within 240 days, if the approval is not coming, I need to file it as a premium?
Yeah, 200 days, not 240, but 200 days, if you don't get an answer, you should premium it. At least call them and inquire. If you don't hear anything, just go ahead and premium the case, because at the end of the day, you won't be able to continue working once you pass the 240 days.
Get it. Okay. And so one more question I have. The old company has revoked the H-1 visa, and the new company has not filed for an H-4 for my husband. So is there any implication on his legal status?
Yes. That means basically he has been out of status since that day it was revoked. So you need to find a solution for him. So it's better either he leaves and waits for your approval and then he comes back, and to make sure he doesn't pass 180 days out of status, otherwise they won't let him come back. So
it is
a big problem. That's why we always recommend to file the H-4 together. And now it's very difficult to file the H-4 because he's already out of status. And how long did you file the case? How long did they cancel the H-1 for you?
They cancelled it very recently, in March. They cancelled it. The old company had filed H-1 and H-4.
March, April, May, June, yeah. He's still under the 180 days, so make sure he doesn't pass that 180 days gap. The 180 days is not a grace period. All it is that it's a forgiven time. That means when he goes outside to get his stamp, they will allow him to get the stamp without creating problems. But once he passes 180 days, they will probably not grant him anything. So be careful under timing, okay?
Yeah, because by filing for the new company, we requested to file an H-4, but they said because your H-4 is already valid till 2021, you don't have to worry.
so they did not file the SO.
No. This is where most lawyers make a mistake, and I repeat that. I've been saying this all the time. The H-4 has no value once the H-1 gets cut off. And since the H-4 attaches to the specific H-1, which is the previous company, and once they cut off that H-1, a lot of lawyers make that mistake because the H-4 doesn't move by itself. So whenever you move to another company, they're supposed to file them at I-539. And by not filing it, they made a mistake.
Get it. So now he has to file it separately?
Yeah. He has to file it, but he cannot file it now from inside because he's already out of status.
Oh, I see. So he has to travel out of the country and then...
Yeah, he has to travel out. But even he travels, he might not get it because your H-1B has not been approved yet. So it's a catch-22 situation. Plus, he needs to watch the time. If he passes the 180 days, he won't be able to come back.
Got it. Okay, sir. Thank you so much.
Good luck to you. Okay?
Sure.
Take care. Bye. This is Shah Peerally, you're live here. I think we don't have more callers right now. So feel free to call. This is Shah Peerally. We are live. Today is June 20th, 2019. And we are going to be here for the next half an hour. So I recommend that you give us a call. If you have any questions, it doesn't have to be specific to employment base. You can call on family base. You can call on asylum. You can call on appeals. RFEs, you name it, as much as I can guide you, I'll be glad to do it. The number to the studio, 510-657-1170. 510-657-1170, that's the number to the studio. Now, if you want to call my office, the number is 510-742-5887. 510-742-5887. And the website to check is peerallylaw.com, or just type attorney on air, attorney one word, attorneyonair.com. Okay, attorney with double T. So, we were talking a little bit about VAWA before we took the callers, because a lot of people, unfortunately, they end up into a really bad relationship or marriage, and it kind of requires, if in case you are victims of such abuses, etc., you can go ahead, even if you can go ahead and file for a VAWA. Let me take another caller. I think we have one caller. So, this is Shah Peerally, you're 11 here.
Hi. Thanks for taking the call. This is Sonia. I have a question for filing the green card for my parents. And so basically the problem is my mom was born in Pakistan, and I don't have my birth certificate. So is there any way to get the birth certificate?
Well, what you need to get is you need to have someone contact there and get what we call an availability of birth certificate. If there was nothing issued. I think I've a caller, right? So, Sonia, are you there? Okay, I'll lose the caller. But just to answer the question, her mother was born before the partition. Usually they understand that an affidavit of birth will do without getting the birth certificate. But if a birth certificate was issued at that time, you better get it. So, get the affidavit of birth and get other secondary evidence. And if you need help, give us a call at the office, 510-742-5887. We'll be glad to help you. Michael, I don't know if I have more callers. Again, the number to the studio, 510-657-1170, 510-657-1170, and then it's 657-1170. And today I have with me Michael on the board, and this is Attorney Shah Peerally for a live show on June 20th, 2019. I think we have another caller, right? Shah, you're live in here.
Hello. Thank you, Sabrin. Thanks for taking the call.
You're welcome, sir.
A couple of questions about N-400. Is it okay to change employers after filing your N-400? Second question is it okay to travel internationally after filing N-400 for a short while?
Yeah, two good questions. The answer is yes, you can change employer, because M400 has nothing to do with that. It might affect if you were working for a company, but then where the green card was obtained, etc., then it can become a problem. But it's not really a problem for N400, so you don't have to worry about the part. Now, I forgot your second question. I got focused on that.
Second question was, is it okay to travel internationally for a short
time? Yes, is it okay to travel? Yes, it is okay to travel, but just don't travel more than 90 days, because once you pass 90 days, there is an issue of jurisdiction and domicile that can come into play. So the best is not to travel at all until you get it. And if you want to travel, make sure that you pretty much kind of have all your paperwork. Well, if you want to travel, as long as you travel within 90 days, you should be fine. Okay?
I see. For the first question, I did not actually get the second part. You said if you're with the employer who sponsored your green card and to change...
I stopped there because it doesn't really affect you. You can't get citizenship until 5 years, so you don't have to stay with that company for that many years. So as long as you work with them after you get the green card for around 6 months, you should be okay.
Oh, okay. So then there could be no issues.
Yeah, no issue then. That's why I stopped, because I kind of thought about it. Hey, you reach citizenship, it's not an issue. Okay?
Right. Okay, good. Thank you so much
for good luck to you.
Yep.
Yeah, let's take another caller, Michael. Hello.
Acha, are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir. I can hear you properly. Go ahead.
Okay, so I was listening to your previous show regarding the out-of-state status due to the passport expiry. So this question is related to that. So, my son, actually, it was I-94 issued because of the passport expiry in the April, last time when we entered in the U.S. And his stamp was still next year, July, and even the IH-4 validity is I-97 till next year. So, we viewed his passport in the month of April, we got the new passport. Just this month he went back to India. So, do you think anything problem while coming back?
No, not at all. It should not be a problem. Unless your H-1B has a major problem, then they will block the H-4. Or if
yeah, my H-1B is valid till next year, and then his H-4 is also valid. Stamp is there, but because of the passport, they issued an I-94 till April this year.
Yeah, no, there's no problem. What I'm saying is that as long as your H-1B is strong, that you have a good company, a good job offer, you should not have a problem to come back. So, it's not an issue.
Sorry, I'm not able to hear properly.
It should not be a problem as long as you have a good job with a good company.
Okay. Okay. Perfect. Thank you very much.
H-1 that has to be good. Good luck to you. Good luck. Another caller, Michael. This is Shah Peerally, 11 here. Hello? Hello. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, feel free to call. Sometimes, you know, you have to bear with me while I'm talking to the people calling. Sometimes it takes longer time, sometimes shorter. So, I apologize for that, but unfortunately, that's the way the system works. And if you have any questions, feel free to call our office. Also, 510-742-5887, 510-742-5887. And again, everything I'm telling you today is for educational purposes only. You should not act or refrain to act solely on the information provided. You should contact an attorney if you have any questions. So, I was talking about VAWA before I started taking the calls, because VAWA is a very powerful tool. One of the things that VAWA does, it blocks the abuser and their family to basically witness against you. You know, like you see, whenever you have a situation where there's a family problems or something, so it's important that you make sure that you keep a documentation or record of all the issues going on. So talking about VAWA now, so if someone is, because of the family issues, I mean, there is something called non-disclosure, and also something that protects the victims from the aggressor. So it's an interesting thing, and I'm very proud to say that we have almost 95% success rate with Avowa. So if you need help on those, you can call our office, 510-742-5887. 510-742-5887. Now, the good thing with Avowa also, you don't have to have entered legally here. And plus, usually if you benefit from other things, you might be able to file also the adjustment of status, etc. for you. Now, the other kind of situation is also what we have under what we call the U visa. For those people who are not married to U.S. citizens or green card holders and they are being abused, they can file for U visa. The problem with the U visa, unlike the VAWA, the U visa requires to get basically a physical abuse situation, and you have to have a police report. The good news with the U visa, it's not only domestic violence, it covers many, many other aspects in terms of, because it covers like 51 crimes. For example, someone has been attacked with a deadly weapon, etc., they get the U visa. The great thing with the U visa, it ultimately leads to a green card, although now it's very much delayed. The U visa, people sometimes don't even know about it. If you have been attacked, you have been abused in certain ways, someone put a gun on your head or something like that, you might qualify for a U visa. You also call the SSS 510-742-5887. 510-742-5887. Now, if you want to call on the studio line, 510-657-1170. 510-657-1170. And we are talking a little bit about the U visa, because the U visa is a very interesting visa. In fact, it's not really a visa, it's a deferred action kind of. So, and that ultimately you can apply for work permit, once the U visa gets approved, then you will have to wait 4 years and then you can file for your citizenship. To your green card. Then after that, of course, you can go for your citizenship. So, ladies and gentlemen, if you need help with either the VAWA or the U visa or any immigration for the matter, feel free to call our office, 510-742-5887. Now, for the studio line today, 510-657-1170, 510-657-1170. This is Attorney Shah Peerally. And like I said, you don't have to ask questions only on the same questions the previous people are calling. It's an open forum when it comes to the radio shows, unless I basically don't take any calls. You can always use other things. So, it is important now for people to know that the U visa and the VAWA doesn't require people to have entered legally. So look into that, because it might be a good backup without you realizing it. Now, the next thing I was going to talk about are the H-1B denials. We're seeing a lot of denials, especially through consultations. Most of them, same problem. They have a good job. They've been doing it for years. Now, suddenly, they're saying these are not a specialty occupation. So, it is really kind of hard on people, especially when they get a big denial. So again, ladies and gentlemen, feel free to call the studio today, 510-657-1170, 510-657-1170. And we are talking, of course, about immigration law, and we're going to shift gear in a bit and talk about debt settlement. I don't know how much time we have left, Michael, so I just want to make sure that we can continue and talk a little bit about debt settlement, and then we'll go back to immigration. Another thing that we help people with are debt settlement. What is a debt settlement is something very different from a debt consolidation. What we do, we basically negotiate your bill with your collection agency and reduce it to a lower amount. And once you basically get that, you're out of the debt. You're out of the debt, and you are also able to start your life again. And we have been doing that for years now with credit cards, etc., etc. So, Michael, please let me know if we have more time. So, I'm going to get back to immigration law, because this is our So this is our main practice, and one of the things that we do all the time right now, we're seeing are people for EB1. Right now, a lot of people are trying to get an EB1, and we had some very good shows with Sharif on that. And also, EB1, you have three categories on them. Number one, you have, thank you, Michael, for letting me know about the time. Number one, EB1 are for extraordinary people on EB1A. And Sharif and I had a very good discussion together on air last time. And you can see that on our YouTube channel, where we discuss about how people can get basically an EB1 without even having publications or things that are listed usually on the website. So these are artistic work. So if you need help when it comes to those cases, please feel free to reach out 510-742-5887 or just email us at info@peerallylaw.com, info@peerallylaw.com, and that will go to all our teams. So if anything is missing, we will know. Now, the other thing that I wanted to talk about are L1As. Excuse me. So, L1As are basically untracked transferee employees. So, for example, let's say you're working in a manager role in India, and your company wants to transfer you, and you have worked for them for 1 year in the past, they might be able to get you what we call an L1A visa, and ultimately getting an EB1C. So a lot of people also move to Canada because suddenly they got Canada. I think we have one caller, right, Michael? Let me take the caller, please. Hello?
Hello?
Yes, Sonia, go ahead.
Hi. Sorry, I got disconnected. This is Sonia again. I asked a question about my mom being born in Pakistan and how do I get the non-availability certificate for her birth certificate.
Yeah, actually, you know, you might not get it. What you will need to do, you will need to find a lawyer in Pakistan to do it. Or you might just put a declaration basically on that, stating that there's no way to get that because of the situation between Pakistan and India. And usually they understand when people were born during the partition and they were at the Pakistani side. So just put a declaration there. Usually, I don't remember, but give me a call at the office. I think I did one case like that. I have to research how we were able to get it there. But I think we used a lawyer there. But also, the other way is to put a declaration explaining because it was before the partition. So you don't need the non-availability certificate. Only thing you will need are the two affidavits. Okay.
Okay. So we can put a declaration along with the affidavit.
Mm-hmm. Yes. You can do that, and then you can explain in there that, and they know about that. It was before the party. Okay.
Okay.
All right. Okay.
Thank you. Good luck to you.
Michael, I don't know how much time we have, but please let me know. So let us talk a little bit. We were talking about L1A because this is an option that many people ask me. They've been waiting on their green card and for years, and they are thinking they are getting tired and they want to leave, but they want to eventually come back. One of the ways to come back after 1 year, if you're working for a branch or a subsidiary or an affiliate of the company, is to come on L1 visas. But L1 visas, there are two types. There are L1As and L1Bs. L1As are for executive and people in managerial role. And the second one, L1B, are for people of a specialty occupation, like technicians. It's good to use the L1 because ultimately the L1 has its own advantage. But the problem with the L1 is not transferable. For example, let's say you come through company A and you want to move to company B, you can't do that. So it is important that you know exactly what how things go. So that you don't lose the chance that you have in the future. And ultimately with the L1A, or even without the L1A, you might qualify directly for the EB1C. If you have spent 1 year within the past 3 years in the foreign country, and you have worked basically in an executive role, then you might be able to also file for an EB1C directly. So for all those evaluations, you can call our office, 510-742-5887, 510-742-5887. The number to the studio today is 510-657-1170, 510-657-1170. And we were discussing, of course, about issues with VAWA, the U visa. Now we're talking about the L1 visa. And again, if you need help basically getting, need help to file those cases, that's what we do, and we'll be glad to help you. Again, 510-742-5887. Now, for the studio line, 510-657-1170, 510-657-1170. So now the other thing that I wanted to discuss are EB1Bs, because a lot of people don't know what it is. And EB1B are professors and outstanding scientists. What it means is kind of the same as EB1A, which is for extraordinary people of extraordinary abilities. But the difference is that it requires an employer. So without an employer, you will not be able to do that. But for EB1A, to start petition, you can file on your own. Also for the National Interest Waiver, which is an EB2, it's still a self-petition, so you're not dependent on anybody else. So it is interesting that if you want to qualify for EB1A or National Interest Waiver, give us a call. We'll be glad to guide you and help you. And again, I think we have 5 more minutes, Michael, so I take a few more callers if there are any callers. 510-657-1170, 510-657-1170, and feel free to call to ask questions. It doesn't have to be on the topics I'm talking about, as long as it is immigration. We'll be glad to help you. So we were discussing, of course, number one, VAWA. Then we talk about U visas. We also talk a little bit covering other topics. And one of the things that is really getting really heartbreaking now are those denials. You have a lot of people who have been here for years, some 12 years, some 16 years, and suddenly they find themselves that they didn't get a chance to deal with things. So I wanted to check. I think, Michael, we have a caller right now. Okay, I kind of heard that. So, if in case you need to call, feel free to call. And now I don't think I have much time to basically take more callers, so I will let you guys call directly the office, 510-642-5887. 510-742-5887. So, we are talking, of course, about all the issues in immigration, and we are seeing, unfortunately, many denials. Not for our office, but mainly for people calling us for consultation. We are seeing a lot of denials, of course, on their big stronghold, which is a specialty occupation. But we are also seeing denials which are quote-unquote kind of ridiculous, but they're still denying it. So what do you do if you get a denial? Well, one option is to file a motion to reopen. Unfortunately, motion to reopen doesn't really work. The second option is actually to sue the government in federal court, because you can do that for H-1Bs. And then, of course, the third option is to refile the case. So you need to know which one fits you best, and that's where a lawyer who can really analyze pretty much can actually work on those cases, it becomes very, very important. Hello?
Hey, this is Amit.
Hey, Amit, how are you? Amit, give me 1 minute and I'll be closing and you can talk a little bit more about settlement, etc. And since today we didn't have a chance to pick up a lot of callers, so I'll let people to be my guest to call the office, 510-742-5887. I wanted to thank Michael for being with us, helping us today, and still I'm trying to recover a little bit from my call. So keep in touch, and we'll be back next week. And again, everything I'm telling you today is my opinion. You should not act or refrain to act solely on the information provided. You should contact an attorney if you have any question. I think you have like 12.